So the way I like to think about it is there's kind of three main families of reinforcement learning algorithms. So the one that's most like what we've talked about so far is what we could call a model-based reinforcement learning algorithm. So model-based reinforcement learning algorithm takes the state action reward tuples that it gets and sends them to a model learner, which learns the transitions and rewards. Those transition rewards, once you've learned them, you could put through an MDP solver, like we've talked about, which could be used to spit out a Q star, an optimal value function. And once you have the optimal value function, you can use, just by taking the argmax of the state that you're in, you can choose which action you should take in any given state, and that gives you the policy. So it's still mapping the state action reward sequence to policies, but it's doing it by creating all these sort of intermediate values in between. Cool. And let me just add one more thing, which is that the model learner takes the history that it's seeing, but it also takes its current estimate of the transitions and rewards to produce the new estimate of the transition rewards. So this is how I want to kind of represent the learning piece of the sequence. Does that make sense? All right. So this is one type. Now let me show you another type. So the second kind of class of reinforcement learning algorithm that's important to think about, they're referred to as value function based, or actually sometimes model free. So the beginning and the end of it are still the same. We're taking sequences of state action rewards and producing a policy. And we even have this Q star in between that we generate the policy from using the argmax. But now, instead of feeding back the transitions and rewards, we're actually feeding back Q star. And we have a direct value update equation that takes state action reward that it just experienced, the current estimate of Q star. Actually, it's kind of more Q than Q star. And uses that to update and generate a new Q, which is then used to generate a policy. Yeah, so instead of explicitly building a model and using it, it just somehow directly learns Q values from values, state actions and rewards. And then a third class of reinforcement learning algorithms comes from the idea that you could sometimes actually take the policy itself and feed that back to a policy update that directly modifies the policy based on the state action rewards that you receive. So in some sense, this is much, much more direct, but the learning problem is very difficult because the kind of feedback that you're getting about the policy isn't really very useful for directly modifying the policy. So here's these three models all together so you can compare and contrast. And you can see, in some sense, they're getting kind of simpler as we go down to policy search, but you could also sort of say that the learning is more direct. And as we go up this way, the learning problems become more supervised in the sense that you can imagine learning to predict next states and next rewards from previous states and previous rewards to learn T and R pretty directly. It's basically a supervised learning problem. You get to see what the output's supposed to be. Here, you don't quite get to see what the output's supposed to be, but you do get values that you could imagine kind of propagating backwards. And here, you get very little useful feedback in terms of how to change your policy to make it better.
Wait, so the way you put that suggests that you should always do one.
Well, so yeah, but look at all the extra stuff that you're doing in between. So, in fact, different problems have different trade-offs as to whether or not which of these is sort of the best thing to do. A lot of the research has been focused on number two, and that's what we're going to be diving into, because in some ways it strikes a nice balance between keeping the computations relatively simple and keeping the learning updates relatively simple. But there are plenty of cases where you'd rather do one and where you'd rather do three.
I look forward to you convincing me that that's true.